Studies of teamwork in operating rooms have found that communication issues among the operating team members can be negative for patient safety. Effective communication is crucial to coordinate team members with different skills and responsibilities and for preventing medical errors. The research we have done shows that we can further advance team communication to increase patient safety. To reduce the risk of miscommunication, researchers and medical practitioners have often focused on the so-called closed-loop communication model as a set of standardized directives for communication. In our research, we have examined this model in the context of surgeries and found room for improvements. These models and protocols, they draw on such concepts as information, senders, and receivers, and really build on early information theories from the 1940s and 50s. Those theories were formulated in the languages of mathematics and engineering and focused on issues related to telephone wires' carrying capacity. But as such, they contained no obvious social components. Instead, we have used the sociological theories of conversation analysis to investigate how work is coordinated in surgery. Based on 58 hours of video recordings, our aim has been to address the functional role of requests in these activities. A second aim was to describe instances of potential miscommunication to understand how what is called conversational repairs were used to address and prevent mistakes. So we could see that there are social mechanisms at play here which can be used to relieve problems of communication. Some of these mechanisms are not made explicit, however, and by making them known and used among the staff, there is a potential to further strengthen teamwork communication. In safety-critical settings, like surgeries, we really want to keep misunderstandings to a minimum because they prolong operation time, and ineffective communication can also be frustrating and lead to tensions between different team members. The results from this study show how it is possible to design the communication so to minimize problems, and this will in turn increase patient safety.